Since they've been racing, they've been wrecking. Many see it as one of NASCAR's attractions, the danger that stalks the dash to the finish line. That danger is real and all too familiar.
Danger, getting killed, getting hurt, getting burned was just part of the deal. You wanted to go racing, you had to put up with it.
The best explanation I can understand is that people that race are people that decide to either accept the risk or they are willing to ignore the risk.
The HANS, or head and neck support, tethers the driver's helmet to a collar. Seat belts placed over the collar ensures the head moves with the body, diminishing whiplash during impact.
In 91, we thought we had something that was refined enough to sell, and we didn't sell many, about 250 in the next 9 years.
I had a HANS device that sat in the transporter for a year. I never put it on. I mean, I tried it once and it wasn't comfortable, and that was that.
I was not at all happy of somebody telling me I had to strap a piece of carbon fiber to my neck, knowing that my vertebrae is a half inch away and my spinal cord's right inside of that.
You cannot expect the racers to use a piece of equipment if it's going to disturb them or bother them, because they want to win. That's their number one goal. And if you do anything that distracts them from that, they aren't going to pick it up and use it.
Safety has greatly improved over the years, but even with drivers securely belted into their cars, the head and neck are susceptible to deadly forces upon impact.
Basilar skull fracture is the most common way that race car drivers have been killed over the years. And I realized that in the crash, the torso is restrained, the head is unrestrained and moves forward. If I could counteract that motion of the head, then I could restrain the head relative to the torso, reduce the neck tension, and essentially eliminate the motions and forces that cause this basilar skull fracture.
Several incidents have shown the effectiveness of the HANS in protecting drivers during head-on collisions.
Whoa, whoa, guys, whoa, whoa, oh no, oh my gosh. I have never seen anything like that in my life.
He hit that wall a ton.
I will guarantee you that impact was well over 180, probably 185 miles per hour.
Some of these crashes, they can see accelerations of like 120, 150 Gs. And the passenger car safety standards think a guy's gonna be dead if he gets 60 Gs.
It's like, oh my gosh. Wow.
This guy hit hard. Still getting it hard.
I've crashed pretty hard in Sprint Cup car and I'm like, man, I should be sore. And 3 days later, you feel fine, so. I don't know, I think it's a huge, huge benefit to all racers out there.
It's second nature now. I mean, you don't even know it's on.
HANS device has been a benefit to all of auto racing. I still believe, though, that some teams and some organizations and some series don't use it to its full benefit.
For more on automotive technology, keep it here on NASCAR.com.